Hi friends, my name is Femi Biwoye. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to populate your drop-down list content from database. So we have a product controller here, and we have a crate. So among all the fields we have in here, I'll probably choose one of these fields as we'll convert it to drop-down list. So I think I'll choose this product condition. Let me choose product condition. So what we need to do is first we create a table for product condition. So I had a new table called product condition, and I'll say ID name and created at. So created that is going to be timestamp, and the default value is going to be current timestamp. The name, we're going to be using the data type of a variable varchar, and the length of 100, while the ID is going to be 100, auto increment. So I think we have majority of the things we need in here, so we'll save. So the next thing we need to do is we go to our G. So we can generate the model for the table we just created. So products condition, no. So I think I will rename this to product condition. So I'll refresh this. It's going to be product condition. So I'll preview. So be sure, in case you want to see what you have there, this is what is going to be generated. So I'll generate. Good. The code has been generated successfully. So let's go back to our IDE and we'll go to backend models to see the model that was recently generated, which is this. Good, we have generated it. So the next thing we need to do is we go to our view and form. So we're using this. So what we need to do is we need to change the name here to drop down list. And the first parameter here is going to be the list that we want to have here. So I will call these conditions. And right now we don't have any value in there, but I'll create a dummy value here to be sure that we have it's working fine. So I'll say this will be, let's say new hold let's say this is special. I think we'll make use of this three as an example. So I'll say I'll refresh. Yes, we now have a list here. So if we check the name and the key, the value and the name, they are both the same. What we have displayed is also what we have as the value in there. So let's go back to our ID and we'll now make sure that this is coming in from database. So this is what we'll do. Let's remove this and we'll go to our controller. So let's test this. just to be sure. So let's kill this. Let me pass this value. Let me kill the page. Sorry, we're supposed to go to our controllers, our crate, instead of, we'll go to crate. Nothing is there. So let's add record to it. So insert, we'll say new hold. So we added two records to it. So let's go back to this place and refresh. We have to record there. So what we need to do now is we'll pass it to the view. Conditions. So we also in our crate view, we also have form passed in through that place. So we need to include the same thing that we had there for this place. Good. So now form. So this is what we need to do. Say array helper map. So we have our list coming in from database. So if we had new record to this place, let's say we have special, I have singles. I'll come back to this place and refresh. We have the record there. Thank you very much. So this is how you will be able to populate your drop down list from database. So like, share, see you in our next tutorial.